Coming up next, Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. It's amazing. And you know what? It ships with DaVinci Resolve Studio. Hi, Sue Lawson here, NAB 2018, with one of my favorite people here. Jason and I have known each other for a few years now. He is awesome. He knows Blackmagic inside and out. He is actually Mr. Blackmagic. Don't tell Grant I said that. But he knows this company. He knows their products. And he's got what is near and dear to my heart. We were so excited this year to hear about the new pocket camera. Totally different pocket camera than what you've had before. But this pocket cinema camera is amazing.
Yeah, thanks so much, dude. That's very kind. We have the new Pocket Cinema Camera 4K, and this is a real, you know, family upgrade for the Pocket Camera to the 4K version of it. In the same way that the Pocket Camera had features in a size that no one ever could have possibly imagined, especially at a price point no one could have possibly imagined, the same thing with the Pocket Cinema Camera 4K. Features the same Micro Four Thirds lens mount. This time we have a Micro Four Thirds sensor in there, so there's no more crop factor. This sensor also has 13 stops of dynamic range, similar to the original Pocket Camera. But this is our first camera in all of Blackmagic's camera history to have a native dual ISO. So the native dual ISOs come in at 400 and 3200 with a max ISO of 25,600. So this is going to be a phenomenal low light camera, which we're all really excited about. Incredibly lightweight and great handheld design. It takes Canon LP E6 batteries that pop out of the hand grip right here. It takes a CFast 2.0 card as well as an SD card. But if you don't want to record to card, there's this nifty little secret on the side of the camera. We have this USB-C port right here. Not only can you power the camera off the USB-C port, but if you have an external hard drive, a portable hard drive, you can plug that right into this USB-C port, bypass your card, and just record straight to a hard drive. Then you could take that hard drive, plug it in your computer, and start editing with DaVinci Resolve or whatever software you're using. The camera also has a full HDMI port, which we're really excited about. So it's a lot more secure port to plug an external video source into for output. And we have these really great function buttons on the top. We have this great dial for changing white balance and shutter speed, trigger record button. We have a trigger record button in the front because we assume that, you know, a lot of vloggers and people doing single person setups are going to be able to just point the camera in front of them for their own videos and hit record just like that. The camera also features a 5-inch touchscreen on the back of the camera. And I'll point it this way so your viewers can check it out. But essentially, it's the same exact Blackmagic operating system that you'll find in the Ursa Mini Pro. So I can easily access Quickfire menu items like zebra stripes for peaking, focus guides, false color, all that information, frame guides, and you can go ahead if you want to change the aperture, you can just click on the button that you want to change. You can just slide your metadata back and forth for adjusting a lot of parameters of the camera. And this camera is going to record in HD, Ultra HD, and DCI 4K at true 4096 by 2160. And it's gonna record ProRes Proxy, Light, 422, HQ, and Cinema DNG RAW in 1:1, 3:1, and 4:1. Yeah, so it's gonna have a lot of recording options, a lot of codecs, and this camera is going to come in at $1,295.
$1,295, that's it, $1,295, it's lightweight. Talk about the weight.
It's very lightweight. This is a prototype. The final version is going to be a little bit lighter than this, but I believe the final version is going to come in at about 1.2 pounds. So it's going to be incredibly lightweight. Even after you get a battery and a lens, maybe a light or a microphone on top of there. Speaking of audio, I forgot to mention we have analog XLR and an 1/8-inch audio input for microphones. But it's going to be extremely lightweight no matter how you really configure it. The last feature I want to mention is for folks that are interested in lookup tables. If you enter in the menu, you'll find that we have a whole page for lookup tables. And we even have a 4K Rec 2020 Hybrid Log Gamma LUT for shooting extended range video directly onto the SD card or whatever your recording media is. So if you have a LUT that you made in DaVinci Resolve that you want to import into the camera, you can do that. And to speed up efficiency and to speed up your workflow, you can record with any LUT baked right into the video. Or you can record log and widen up your post-production options later on. The choice is yours.
The choice is yours. The price, $1,295, I mean, really. If this was available right this second and there wasn't security all over the place, I would be walking out with three or four of them. It's not shipping yet, though. It's shipping
in September.
We were talking about the workflow between this and DaVinci Resolve. Resolve big changes with that as well. They just keep getting better and better and better. So Blackmagic design, absolutely awesome. We're going to take a look at DaVinci Resolve as well. So hang with Jason and I here at NAB 2018.